break it down to level 3นะครับ that mean we break the prepare the site into small piece of work นะครับ now this is example we may have more okay but if we think that is itbecause the project is big and complex นะครับ is it not easy to manage and control this kind of work becauseThere are many more activities included in each group. Then we need to break it down further into small level. Like for example, level 4. Okay. And we take survey the site as an example. Okay, for breaking down into small manageable activities. Okay. So for survey the site, okay, it may be activity determine the site boundary.Okay. So before you do a construction, before you do the project, you need to check okay, the site boundary, okay, whether is it correct or not. Site boundary means แนวเขตที่ดิน okay, in the title deed. Okay, ก็คือแนวเขตที่ดิน title deed ก็คือโฉนด okay. You need to define the datum point for elevation, okay, datum point benchmarkOkay, you need to set up the temporary benchmark. Okay, to locate building footprint. Okay, building footprint is boundary of the building. Now, a perimeter of the building. Okay, locate building service. Okay, the services that buried in under the ground. Okay, if it's not.Small enough, then you need to further breaking it down. You have to further break it down. This is called work breakdown structure. Okay, so it go on to small pieces. Okay, to break it down until we are sure that we can manage and control it. But it should not be too small. Okay, if it is too small mean.You break it down until you think that you can finish it in 1 or 2 days. Is it not good for you? Okay, because if the activity is very, very small, okay, that is can finish in 1 or 2 days, you cannot do any other thing. Okay, because you need to supervise and control that kind of activity to finish in 1 or 2 days, or else the project may be delayed.Okay, so break it down to the level that you think you can manage and control it easily. Okay, or control it effectively. Okay, this is example of precast housing. Okay, precast housing project or precast residential villa. Okay, we have planning, engineering.Production, delivery, election, and over. Okay, then for planning, you break it down into engineering plan, production plan, delivery plan, okay, something like that. Okay, so this is level one. Okay, work breakdown structure level one. Okay, this is level two, level three. You can further break it down this into level four, level five. Okay, for each group.Because you cannot perform the task in the project, okay, by each group. For example, first of all, okay, when you say first of all, there are many, many activities including in the first of all. Okay, so this is too rough. Okay, is it too rough? Okay, then we need to break it down further.Okay. So this is the work breakdown structure, okay, for a house. Okay. Okay. So in here you can see that when we break it down, okay, the house, okay, we have a work, okay, that in the percentage and the budget, okay, that used for each activity. Okay. For example.Equation, okay. Equation we have equate, okay, for concrete, kill step from kill and step from นะครับ so network is include 18.2% 7.9% 10.3% นะครับ and the budget นะครับ budget that we can acquire from cost estimation นะครับ from BOQ bill of quantity นะครับ that the cost estimator perform it I have done it นะครับ once project is broken down into tasks or activities นะครับ then we can organize or build the project on the paper นะครับ build the project on the paper I mean you do a project schedule นะครับThe activity must be organized by the order of the tasks to be performed. นะครับ the chronological order. นะครับ order of the task to be performed. Chronological order. นะครับ this is a work breakdown structure that we call. นะครับ so let's see example of bridge construction project นะครับ using bar chart support that we have a project นะครับ for bridge construction นะครับ so this is a elevation view or front view of the bridge นะครับ we have abutment here นะครับ abutment is the structure that we use to protect the soil นะครับ the soil from the edge of the bridge นะครับ to slide into the river นะครับ that's it called abutment นะครับ if you take a top eye view นะครับ the shape will look like this for abutment นะครับ the shape will look like this นะครับIt used to protect the soil. You have to slide into the river. That's called abutment. We have to do a piling. In the river. We have piling work in the river. Here we have pile cap column. Pier cap, and then this is called.Substructure and this is called superstructure. นะครับ for substructure include pile, pier cap, a pile cap column, pier cap. นะครับเป็น super sorry column. Superstructure include pier cap. นะครับ concrete deck. นะครับ beam, slab, structural steel beam something like that. นะครับ This is the plan of top high view. นะครับ we have abutment. Over here, นะครับ we have a column. นะครับ column over here or substructure. นะครับ that's it built into the river. นะครับ built into the river. Support that the river come from the top. นะครับSo from the plan, นะครับ the elevation will look like this, นะครับ So in this, นะครับ when you take a look in this, you need to break it, นะครับ break the project down into small activities, นะครับ into small activities. So you can see that you have abutment work, นะครับ to do abutment, นะครับ because area around this นะครับ maybe นะ area around this นะครับ may not be ready for construction or for doing the abutment นะครับ then we need to clear it first clear the land first that we call clearing and grubbing นะครับ now we need to clear the area first นะครับ for the workin the river นะครับ the work in liver นะครับ we have piling นะครับ to dry the pie or to do a ball pie นะครับนะ do a ball pie you need to have a temporary structure นะครับ in order to dewater นะครับ to do a with dewatering นะครับ to keep the area dry so that you can do the work นะครับ then you need a temporary structure over here and over here that we call cofferdam นะครับ so you break it down into activities นะครับ and list it in chronological order นะครับ in order of the work to be performed นะครับ so in the drawing you cannot see these activities นะครับ this activity you need to think it by yourself นะครับ first before you start the project you need to mobilize นะครับ you need to mobilize two equipment นะครับ and worker into the project site นะครับ and then you need to set up the temporary structure for example labor camp storage areaworking area site office something like that นะครับ that we call mobilize นะครับ so for mobilization you can further breaking it down into small pieces for example labor camp doing labor camp นะครับ construct the site office and working area something like thatWe have a submittal, work submittal, okay? That means you need to get approval for using material and get approval for chalk drawing, that we call submittal. Okay. The temporary structures, okay, that we need to do, okay, in order to keep the site dry, okay, that we call cofferdam. Okay. So cofferdam, okay.You can see that is it not shown in the drawing นะครับ you need to know it by yourself นะครับ this is the method of construction นะครับ piling work นะครับ piling work you need to think the method of construction as well because you can see that in here นะครับ in the front view นะครับ or elevation view นะครับ pine work นะครับ is it not drive vertically นะครับ driving 15 degree นะครับ sway นะครับ in the direction นะครับ15 degree to the vertical axis นะครับ this one is to keep it used to resist the horizontal load, horizontal force. For example, the force from the lever, force from the chip or the barge that hit the pie cap. That is why they need to drive it into the diagonal direction.So we have piling work, นะครับ pie cap, นะครับ column, pier cap, and for the superstructures, we have a structural steel beam, นะครับ concrete deck beam, and then slab, นะครับ of pavement, นะครับ and we may have more on that, นะครับ we may have curb, we have rail work.We may have electrical light pole. We may have a sign, traffic sign, something like that. And drain water drain it, something. But in here, is it not include all of the work? This is only example for support that we break it down. All of the work.นะครับ but in fact is it not complete นะครับ the activity is not complete นะครับ but we support that it's okay. Like, so we have peer cap, we have the steel structure, steel beam, steel deck, concrete deck. For abutment, we have we need to create first called curing and grubbing, in order that the area will be suitable for doing the abutment. Which is clear form, sharp clear form, small tree, something like that. And finally, when the project is going to hand over, the committee need to come to check whether the work is complete and free from defect. That if there are some defect, then they take a note or they list it down into the document that we call punch list. It's the method of checking before transferring the project to the owner. So mobilize the first task before we draw an horizontal bar, we need to make a time scale. In here, time scale is in week. It's in week. You may have time scale in days or in month. It depends on the purpose of bar chart that you are using. So for mobilize, suppose that we are the planner, then we think that mobilization work must need 2 weeks to finish. Then it is the first task. Then we draw the horizontal the bar horizontally from the starting of the project. This is the starting point of the project. Need 2 weeks to complete, then draw it from the starting point to the end of week 2. Submit to work, because there are many things, many material, many shop drawing to submit to get approval from from supervisor, from consultant. Then we think that we need 7 weeks to do it, to perform. Then this can do it from the starting point of the project and finish it at the end of this week 7. Once the mobilization complete, then the project can start. The first task of the project is cofferdam. To do a temporary structures in the river. It's for cofferdam. Then cofferdam start once mobilization finished. And we estimate that it may be finished within 3 weeks. Then draw it from week starting of week 3 and finish in week 5. After that, the pile work begin. Pile cap, column, pier cap, erect steel, concrete deck. You can see that from this. For pile work, we have three location. Pile work over here, over here, over here. Once the pile work finished, the equipment will move to the second location to do a pile work. And then this finish move into this location to do pile work. Then you need not to wait until the all of the pile work finished. Once this one finished, the equipment move to do this. Then you can start doing the pile cap, pier column, and pier cap. Once this finished, equipment move to this, then you can start doing this. That's it why you see that the work for pile cap, column, pier cap, leg steel, concrete deck, overlap. For piling, there are three locations, so it means that it needs 1 week to finish the second part, the first location. For each location, it needs 1 week to finish. So the location one finished, then the pile cap can นะครับ can start นะครับ as well นะครับ it need 1 week to finish นะครับ for column นะครับ column needs 2 week นะครับ for abutment นะครับ because abutment is located on the bank of the river นะครับ on the bank of the river then it can performconcurrently it can perform dependently นะครับนะ it can perform dependently นะ then start with killing doubling work and then abutment on left side and right side นะครับ so this one นะครับ it take 2 weeks to finish for east side of the abutment นะครับ however youNow, when you take a look in here, you can see that the structural steel beam, cannot be pressed, if this one or this one has not been finished yet. It means that structural steel work need to wait until pier cap and abutment finished. If either one has not been finished yet, then structural work cannot start.นะครับ on this side as well นะครับ on the middle location นะครับ the concrete deck concrete beam cannot start นะครับ cannot start if pier cap on this side or this side has not been finished yet นะครับ this one as well นะครับ that means that the structural steel or the concrete deck beamneed to wait for 2 activities this one or this one or this one or this one so you can see that for this abutment finish over here so Elex steel can start because the column finish over here except that if the abutment had not been finished it delay until here then if it delay until here theUntil here, so suppose that it delay until this. Then you can see that because the steel structure can win start only when abutment and pier cap finish. So if this delay, the electric steel cannot start, because it will start on this point. However, you can see that for this one, the project will be finished in in 25 weeks, right?Finish in 25 weeks. But for this one, we break this. Now we do a work breakdown structures. That very rough. You can see that we include all the prior work into one activity. But in fact, there are T-location for piling work. The T-location for pile cap for column.For pier cap and for abutment, we have 2 locations on the right and on the left, on the left side and right side. So when we make it into one activity, piling work, if any location delay, for example, the first location delay a little bit, we cannot notice it. For the second location, it further delay. We cannot notice it clearly.Until we do a work in the third location, and we can notice the delay. Up to here, we cannot make any correction right away because the activity is delayed largely. So to make it easily to manage and control this kind of project,We should separate the pie work, pie cap column into location. So it will look like this นะครับ we have copper dam pier number 1 number 2 number 3 pipe pier number 1 number 2 number 3นะครับ so we can control it easily if this one delay นะครับ then you can see that นะครับ we cannot start the pier cap number 1นะครับIf pier cap number 1 delay, we cannot start pipe cap number 1, something like that. So when we break it down into small activities, this one, we can control the work effectively, the abutment as well. And the project still finished within 25 days. But we can control the projecteffectively so that is the method that we use for do a project schedule so you can see that bar chart show operation time that consumed by each operation or activities that for ordering material notice required can easily be noted on the chart and seen it means that we can use bar chart to take note for material order or for notice that required for doing activities something like that using bar chart we can show the schedule นะครับin comparison with the actual progress okay. so you can check the your actual progress with the schedule okay. and ease of recording progress okay. so this is method for recording progress of activitiesBecause for activity, we cannot see the progress of it easily because the when we use bar chart, it draw according to time scale. Okay, so this one it will tell us that it need 2 weeks to finish. Is it week? Okay, is it need 2 weeks to finish? This one 1 week. This one is 2 weeks to finish. Okay, if we use a yellow color for the actual progress of the work or actual progress of activities you can see that for this one the first activity it start according to our plan but it finished early that means that we can perform it efficiently it finished in 1.5 weeks once it is finished then this one will start concrete foundation is start we start early because the plan will start on beginning of week 3 but this can start with beginning of 2.5 weeks but however it finish on week 3 for the fixed column work to install the column work our plan we plan to finish it within 3 weeks take 3 weeks to finish but in the activity progress we can draw it in 2 weeks now that means that it shows us that now we spend 2 weeks to perform the task on the plan it takes 3 weeks to finish. It means that it must finish 33.3% for each week, 33.3% for each week. But for this, even though we spend 2 weeks already, but it doesn't tell us that it finished two-thirds of the work. Okay, it just tells us that we spend two-thirds of the time.Two-thirds of the time, but the work may be finished more than or less than two-thirds, right? Now, if there are some delay, there are obstacle, then the work may be finished less than, นะครับ less than the time that we spend, นะครับ so to record the activity progress act, นะ to record the activity progress we need to have a quorum, นะครับ we need to provide quorum in front of the time scale, นะครับ so for this one activity has already finished then we don't support that we have 10นะครับ10 square นะครับ each square represent 10% นะครับ so it already finished then mean it is 100% finished this one 100% finished but for this one even though you spend 2 weeks already you have just 1 week more to finish the project but it doesn't tell that you finished two-thirds of the week two-thirds of the work นะครับ support that you spend 2 weeks already but because there are many obstacles many difficulties in the project then you can finish it 10% of the work only นะครับ then you need to record it here 10% นะครับ even though you spend 2 weeks นะครับ on your plan it must be finished two-thirds of the work but here you finish only 10% นะครับ you finish only 10% นะครับ that means that your work is delayed นะครับนะ you finish only 10% rather than your plans say that you need to finish two-thirds or 66.7 นะครับ so this is the method to record the progress of activitiesนะครับ because we cannot see the progress of activity on the bar chart on the bar this is another method นะครับ that we can can record the progress of activity นะครับ using dotted line นะครับ support that this is the plan our plan we have 3 activity นะครับ activity aนะครับ take 4 unit of work activity B take 4 unit of work activity C take 1 unit นะครับ support that we work we spend 2นะครับ2 week or 2 month already and we want to check the progress of our work then we go into the project site to check นะครับ support that activity finish 40%Activity B finished 50%. Activity C has not been started yet. okay. So from your plan, okay, when you finish 2 weeks, okay, activity B must complete 50%. Okay, half of the bar is 50%. Activity B, okay, is only 1/4, 25%.นะครับ and activity C has not been started นะครับ but in actual นะครับ you check into the project site is it you finish only 40% that means you are 10% behind นะ you are 10% delay for activity A นะครับ for activity B you finish 15% but in fact it must be 25% that you also delay 10% นะครับ for activity BThen from this you interpret, นะครับ นะ the total bar is 100%, นะครับ 40% is around here, นะครับ 50% 15% around here, นะครับ Then you draw that dotted line, นะครับ to cut through the activity A, activity B, and then intersect month 2, นะครับ So you already know that.Activity A 10% behind, activity B 10% behind. Then for the next month, นะครับ month number 3, นะครับ you need to take an action in order to buy the time back, นะครับ to buy the time back, นะครับ you need to remain hard worker to do overtime work, you need to accelerate the activities, นะครับ by adding more to admin more worker or ask worker to do overtime work นะครับ support that monthly finish นะครับ when we finish on monthly นะครับ we go into the project site we check that we have a total we have activity A 70% complete in overall นะครับ 70% complete activity B 50% activity C 50%นะครับ but in our plan on our plan นะครับ activity A must be 25% complete activity B is 50% and activity C 100% นะครับ so from here you can see that นะครับ A 25% but we complete 70% นะครับ on month 2 it is 10% behind but now นะครับ we can นะ we can speed up นะครับ and นะ up to here now 5% behind นะครับ activity B นะครับนะ on the plan is 50% and then you can see that นะครับ we are now already 50% นะครับ which is all the plan or all schedule นะครับนะ but activity C นะครับ in our plan in on the plan นะครับ it must be 100% complete but now we have finished only 50% now, maybe that activity C has many difficulties นะครับ to do this kind of task or this kind of activity then the activity can finish only 50% นะครับ even though we finish it on month 3 then we draw a dotted lineSo this is another method to record the activity progress. But for this one, is it not good for the project that has activities more than 50 activity? A project that has more than 50 activity. Because if the project is quite big and there are many activity, recording using the dotted line will be confused.นะครับ will be confused นะครับ to the record the overall progress of the project we use นะ the overall progress of the total project we use the curve that we call S curve because the shape it look like the letter S นะครับ that's why they call S curve นะครับ to plot the S curve นะครับ you need to have two axis นะครับ the first axishorizontal axis is the time นะครับนะ is the unit of time นะครับ the vertical axis is the unit of cost or unit of work นะครับ unit of cost or unit of work you may use the definitive value or you may use the relative value นะครับ relative value mean you convert it into percentagenะครับ so this is for the total project นะครับ support that is it it take 250 day to finish then 250 day is 100% นะครับ and then if it is 45 day then you can convert 45 day into present นะครับ that is called relative value นะครับ or you can usedefinitive value นะครับ for example 10 20 40นะครับ until 250นะครับ on the vertical axis as well นะครับ it is the cost it is the budget it is the value of work นะครับ or value of the project นะครับ you can use a relative value or definitive value as well นะครับ so to plot S curve you can see thatWe use accumulative value, นะครับ accumulative value, นะครับ นะครับ so let's say example of the beach project, นะครับ suppose that we have a cost or budget for each activity, นะครับ we have cost or budget for each activities.นะครับ to plot S this S curve นะครับ we need to use cumulative value นะครับ from the starting point of the project until the ending point of the project นะครับ So the total cost or the total budget of the project is the summation of all of the cost of all activities. Because for that, when we sum that, is it the budget of the project is 1,604. Right, 1,604. Okay, 1,604,000. Okay, so to plot S curve, okay, first you need to know the cost of each activities. Okay, cost of each activity. Then you need to compute the value to date. Okay, value to date mean value of each period. In here, period is in week. Then you need to compute, okay, the cost of each week. Okay, cost of each week. Okay. So for the week number one, we have mobilization, we have submittal work, we have only two activity. But for submittal work, okay, they will define there's no cost. Okay, cost will be zero, but in fact, in real project, okay, the cost of submittal, okay, there is a cost of submittal. But in here, support that we don't have cost for submittal. Then for week number one, we have only mobilization work. Okay. So the cost of mobilization, okay, is 25,000, and it takes 2 weeks to finish. Okay. It takes 2 weeks to finish. Okay. In the real construction project, you need to think by yourself. Okay. How much cost will be on week one and how much cost will be on week two? It may not be equal, or it will be equal. It's up to your decision. Okay. It's up to you, to the decision of the planner. Okay. For example, if the planner think that they are not ready for work, or they cannot work efficiently 100% and in full capacity, okay, then they think that the work will be small. Okay. Then they may have, for example, they think that they can finish it 25%. Okay. Then the cost will be 25% of the total. Okay. And the second week will be 25% of the total. Okay. But to make it simple in the class, okay, to make it simple in the class, we assume that, okay, the cost of the task, okay, will be divided equally, okay, for each period, okay, will be equally, okay, will be an equal portion, okay, so that this one take 2 weeks to finish, then the cost will be 25,000 divided by 2. Okay. For cofferdam, okay, it takes 3 weeks to finish, then the cost will be in equal for each period. Then is it 48,000 divided by 3. Okay? Okay. For the class, okay, support that the cost incur equally in each period of that activity. Okay. But in real project, okay, you need to make decision by yourself. Alright? Okay. So for week one, we have only one activity. In fact, we have two activity, but this one has no cost. Then we have mobilization. The cost for week one will be 25,000 divided by 2, which is 12,500. Okay. 12,500 is cost to date. Okay. Cost for week one. Cost for week two as well, we have only one activity. Okay. Cost for week three, we have submittal, call for them, and clearing and clubbing. Okay. Then you need to sum all of the costs down. Okay. For week three, okay, for this one, this is 16,000, right? Divide 48 divided by 3 is 16. 16 plus 8,000, then will be 20. Is it not 16,000? 16, okay, 16,000 plus 8,000 will be 24,000. Okay. Then you sum, you calculate, okay, cost to date for each week. นะครับ now for example for week 24นะครับ we have only one activities this is the concrete deck นะครับ the budget is $675,000นะครับ675,000 in take 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 weeks นะครับ then you divide by 12นะครับ you get 56,250นะครับ and finally the punch list นะครับ it take 2 weeks finish the cost is 2,000 then it is 1,000 each what happened cannot use nนะครับนะ it นะ the cost to that is 1,000 each for punch list นะครับ so this is the cost to that but to plot S curve we don't use the cost to that to plot it นะครับ because it is the accumulative value นะครับ or the accumulation of cost นะครับ then you need to compute the accumulationนะครับ so accumulation นะครับ it is the summation of cost to date from starting point to the end of the project นะครับ so for week 1นะครับ starting is 0 week 1 is 12,500 then 0 plus 12,500 is 12,500 นะครับ core accumulation for week 2 you use the accumulation for week 1 plus cost to date for week 2 to beaccumulation of week 2 นะครับ plus this to be accumulation of week 3 plus this นะครับ until the end of the project นะครับ the total core accumulation cost will be the total amount of the project which is equal to 1,604,000 นะครับ 1,604,000 นะครับ if you want to plot it using the definitive valuenะครับ then the vertical axis will be the definitive value นะครับนะ this one will be 1,604,000 นะครับ but actually นะครับ we prefer to plot it using relative value นะครับ so relative value mean you convert the accumulative value the definitive value into percentage นะครับso the total value is 100% นะครับ this one will be equal to 3.05% นะครับ3.05% come from 49,000 divided by 1,604,000 multiplied with 100นะครับ you get 305นะครับ so you can see that the percentage will be add upนะครับ to the end of the project is 100% นะครับ then we use this value to plot the S curve นะครับ for week 1นะครับ it is 0.08 over here week 2 1.56 week 3 305นะครับ week 22 is 96.73 นะครับ week 24 is 99.94 andfinally week 25 is 100% นะครับ so we can obtain the S curve for this project นะครับ how to use this S curve นะครับ we use it to compare with our actual performance นะครับ or actual progress นะครับ to plot the actual progress you need to plot it one at a time that means that if you want toreport your progress at the end of each week นะครับ then you go into the project site and measure the your performance นะครับ the total completed work นะครับ and then multiply with the amount of work นะครับ or the budget of worknะครับ to get the accumulative value of actual work นะครับ then you plot it one for each week นะครับ suppose that we come up to week 10นะครับ to week 10นะครับ then we plot at week 10 over here นะครับ in here we can interpret that our actual work นะครับ make progress more than our plan นะครับ because on our plan นะครับ at the end of week 10 the progress of work that we plan is only about nearly 40% นะครับ nearly 40%This is about 38 point something. Suppose that's 38.6. Okay. But in our actual progress, our actual work, okay, we already finished about 50%, okay, 50.2%. Okay. So we can see that plan progress is, okay, progress on our plan is 38.6, but progress for our actual performance is 50.2.นะครับ that mean that at the end of week 10 we are ahead of schedule นะครับ we are ahead of schedule we our work นะครับ is ahead of the plan นะครับ about how many 11 point not 11 12 right 11.6นะครับ11.6%นะครับ if we ask how many week that we are ahead of schedule how many week that we are ahead of schedule then we can project it back นะครับ from this point นะครับ from the week 10 back to our actual progress นะครับ so the difference between this นะครับ is the the number of week that we are ahead of schedule นะครับ so from here is it about nearly 2 week ahead of schedule นะครับ or you can project from here to intersect over here นะครับ and the difference between these two lines นะครับ is the นะ we show the ahead of workThis also นะครับ another example นะครับ This one show that the project is behind schedule because it is below the S curve นะครับ of the plan นะครับ below the S curve of the plan นะครับ This mean that the our work is behind schedule นะครับ behind schedule then we need toTake an action นะครับ in order to buy the time back นะครับ by doing overtime work นะครับ by adding worker by using the new construction technology something like that นะครับ in order to keep the our work on track นะครับ that this is all schedule okaySo that's all on about the bar chart นะครับ So bar chart is every favorite นะครับ both technical and non-technical people นะครับ because it easy to draw นะครับ using simple graphic representation it means using using the bar นะครับ to represent the time to perform the activitiesIt is easy to read and understand and can grasp this schedule information quickly. Okay. Need not to search for managerial skill. That means that any people can understand it easily. There's no need extensive training. Okay.So bar chart can be used as an effective communication tool. Okay, it can be used as effective communication tool because it is straightforward. Is it well understood? Okay, is it well understood? Okay, using simple relationship between activities. Okay, using the bar.And very popular for representation of simple schedule. It means that it is good for simple project. Okay, simple project, the small project, simple project. However, is it not good for the big project, big and complex project? Okay. Because bar chart can be cumbersome. Okay. It will be difficult to understand when there are more than 50 activity. Okay. Another weakness of bar chart is that there's no dependency capture among activity. Okay. So the planner will know himself, but the user may not understand, okay, the relationship, interrelationship between activity query. Okay. Now the user may not understand the relationship between project activity query. For example, let's see this. Okay. That I already told you, okay, for steel election, okay, we need peer cap of this side and the abutment, right? But in here for bar chart, okay, you may misinterpret that the elector steel need only this activity to finish. Okay. That means this activity can start only when this finished, but in fact it need to wait for this one as well. Okay. This is the problem of bar chart or weakness of bar chart. Okay. It means that it cannot show relationship among activity query. Okay. So it cannot be used to calculate specific project activity start date, completion date, and available float. Okay. Available float is the extra time that the activity can delay without impacting the delay of the project. Okay. That is called float. Okay. I will explain in more detail later on, okay, for the float when we come up to the when we come up to the network analysis, okay, which is another tool for doing a schedule. Another weakness is that status of individual activity can be readily ascertained, but overall status of project cannot be determined, okay, when some activity are not on schedule. So it will make us, okay, difficulty to accept the need for making schedule adjustment. Okay. Change in the plan require extensive redoubling if you draw it by hand. Okay, if you make the bar chart by hand. Okay, when you make change in the plan, okay, you need to do it from the starting point. Okay, that means extensive redoubling. But if you use a computer software package nowadays, okay, this is not a problem anymore. This is not the weakness anymore. Because the computer program will adjust it according to our chain. Okay. So bar chart is the most effective, okay, as the reporting format only, rather than using it as a representation. Another weakness is that bar chart it does not relate activity to the location of work. Okay. Suppose that if it is the road highway construction project, okay, we may want to know the location and the time. Okay. For example, on this day we want to know where the work is. Okay. Where the work is in what station, okay, in what kilometers, okay, that the work is going on, okay, bar chart cannot tell us. You can overcome this weakness using the link bar chart นะครับ using the link bar chart or monitoring bar chart นะครับ but if the project is quite big and complex นะครับ link bar chart is not suitable either because it will make us to get confused นะครับ this is example of link bar chartOkay, mean that you use the dotted line, the dotted arrow, okay, to join the activities so that you can understand it clearly. For example, this one, construct in situ span, okay, it need to wait for substructure center and substructure each direction. Okay, but if you don't have if you don't have dotted arrow okay, you may interpret that construction is too span will depend on this activity onlyนะครับ depend on this activity only นะครับ but in fact นะครับ it need to wait for substructure center as well นะครับ this one also นะครับ and this one นะครับ if we don't have it นะครับ we can think that นะครับ surface bit will wait for construction is to span only นะครับAnd this is the kind of link bar chart. So in summary, bar charts will suit for simple project, okay, short-term program used for communicating with people involved, okay, especially okay, we use bar chart.To communicate with worker, okay, we use it to communicate with supplier, and we usually use it to communicate with the owner of the project, okay, because they don't have technical knowledge, okay, to understand the not to understand the project, okay, so if we use bar chart, okay, we can communicate with them.Easily, okay. Bar chart, however, bar chart are not suitable for detailed program of complex project. Okay, it is not suitable for evaluating the project duration and displaying activity interdependency, okay. Relationship between or relationship among activities.Okay, so that's it, the bar chart. Okay, I will leave this tennis court project okay, as your homework. Okay. So I will put it in assignment. Okay, just one homework. Okay, and this one we need not to do it. So this is the end of bar chart schedule using bar chart. Do you have any question about bar chart?